Hello, it's me, Cy Rodriguez, and I am here today in Hungary by the grapes and lots of gardens. It's a pretty nice place as far as how many people grow stuff in their own yard. It's actually amazing. Unfortunately, a lot of them spray stuff on their food, so that part is kind of, it's just the reality right now. And hopefully it's going to change, but it's kind of sad when you're looking for organic stuff. But today I'm here to talk with you about liberty and being authentic. And I'm wearing my Statue of Liberty t-shirt that my mother-in-law got me when she was traveling in the United States area on a boat, and decided to get a Statue of Liberty shirt for myself and for one for my wife as well. So anyways, about liberty. First, freeing your mind. This is the first step, and it is what is going to help you along the rest of the journey. It's what's going to make you feel a little better in all of the craziness of the world. And that is why I think it's so important to be authentic in the time that we live in. And so in being authentic, I'm always thinking about, am I being real? Am I really expressing who I truly am? And even right now, I don't feel like I'm fully expressing who I truly am, because who I am truly is probably just pretty relaxed in a funny way. Like, I'm always trying to be funny. I like to sing. I'm always making silly noises. I have kids, so I'm entertaining them to some degree sometimes, and they're entertaining me too a lot of the time. So I have just been thinking about the programming that is all around us, and it's everywhere. But what a lot of people don't know or may not realize is that this programming that's going on has been being implemented into our society for a long, long, long time. So if you go back to the 1930s, there were books written about what was going to happen with society and what was going to be needed to keep people basically under control, and people thinking in sort of a communistic sort of way about how the world was going to be, and how there would be more and more laws and rules implemented, and that it needed to be done in a way where it wouldn't be too much, because if it was too much, then people might rebel. It could be devastation because people wouldn't put up with it. So they had to be really smart about how they were going to implement this. And they were thinking in terms of what would be best for everybody. So for example, they were thinking in terms of, well, does a parent really have a right to be with their children if they don't know what the best way to healthfully grow them into mature adults was? And the thinking was along the lines of that, no, parents don't have the right just because they want to be around their kid, because even in being around their kid, they might not know what is best for their kid, I guess is the best way to put it. So I'm just waving to somebody over here. And so basically they're thinking that, oh yeah, even the parent doesn't have a right to be the one who is the caretaker of their kid if they don't know how to be a parent properly, according to what they believe to be proper. So this to me, I'm sorry, but is just completely unacceptable, and I'm very passionate about this. I am so anti-rule, anti-government, anti-authority, that sometimes I have to check myself to make sure that I'm not just rebelling because somebody was telling me that they thought I should do something. Maybe that what they said that I should do is good, and I have to to check myself so that I consider what's coming into me sometimes, even if it comes in a way where somebody seems like they're telling me what to do. And I think that that is human nature. So in a utopian society, if that could be, then communistic way of life would be maybe good, because then everybody would be like robots and do exactly what they were supposed to do, and things would just roll along in the way that the utopian idea about how things could be, they just be the way that those people envisioned, or that maybe even you could envision it being. But that's not human nature, and I don't think anybody wants to be a zombie or to be controlled. And I think that the more that you implement controls, the more sick the society becomes. Being good is a choice. Deciding to treat other people in a way that you would like to be treated is a choice. But when you put it on somebody to force them into a certain way of being, then I think it not only hurts them on a whole physical, mental way, all of it's connected anyway, but it also makes them to be somebody that they're not. And this is the programming, the deep kind of programming I'm talking about. So what I'm saying is don't even be the person who has the persona of I'm out of the box. Be the person who is freaking crazy, like me. And that's what I'm saying is just be yourself, even if it means that you have to surprise everybody and do something that is completely out of your character so that they don't hold you into their impression of who you should be. Be who you want to be. And if that is somebody who is pleasing to other people, then I say more power to you. There's nothing wrong with being a nice and good person to other people, but don't confuse passive aggression with being a good person, or being nice because you want other people to like you, with really truly being authentic. Because being truly authentic requires you to be disturbed sometimes, to not agree. And I think that is human nature, to not agree with people who want to control you. And a perfect example of this is, before I give an example, since my mind is going all over, just think about what it's like to be an animal. So even the animals are being more and more controlled, but animals can walk wherever they want to walk. They can pee wherever they want to pee. They could basically do whatever it is that they do naturally. But as people, we're told that we can't even sleep outside unless we pay a fee. We're told that we can't pee outside unless we pay a fine. We're told that we can't walk in certain areas because we'll disturb the nature. I'm sorry, but I'm an animal, at least on a physical level, and I was not meant to be confined in a little tiny shelter. And here's the other thing that I was going to say about communistic ideas, is that there's always people who are in control, which I know you know these things, but these people are going to tell you what to do, and they are going to take the best rations of everything. So they're going to get the best coffee, if that's their thing. They're going to get the best vegetables, the best fruits, all of the best foods, the best living quarters. They're going to have access to all of the things that maybe not everybody else has access to, like planes to take them all over in the world. And when you really think about that, it makes you really say, wait a minute, so am I going to be the one who is going to be the slave laborer doing what it is that somebody else told me was my best, or my the thing that I had the highest aptitude for? Like, I'm going to go and be a farm laborer because somebody said that my aptitude was best suited for that, and their aptitude was best suited to be sitting at a fancy desk and flying around the world in their airplanes telling people what to do? No. Uh-uh. Not going to happen. Not for me. Hopefully not for you. And I hope that because of this, that you will stand up and just do what it is that you want to do. And have respect, can be considerate of the world and people, and realize that nobody's perfect, but don't stop yourself just because you think somebody else might not approve of what you're doing. And I want to just give an example of capitalism here. I am a business person. I'm an entrepreneurial-minded person. And I have to check myself all the time because I'm always thinking, well, is what I'm thinking about doing, is this really just trying to profit at the cost of destroying the world? And sometimes I really wonder, like on some level, if I think about manufacturing something, is it something that I should manufacture? Is it something good to manufacture? Or is it really going to long-term be something that is just wasteful and takes more than what it gives? And it's something I have to consider. But being an entrepreneur, from my perspective, is one of the very, very best things that you can do, so that you can take back the power and take it away from this centralized power society where it's going to only the big brand names. Make your own brand. Be the person who runs your own business instead of feeling like you have to go and work at Walmart. Be the next Walmart, but only be a way better Walmart, and encourage other people to be a better Walmart, you know, with really good stuff that people really need, and also one that encourages and supports other businesses to be there as well. And probably Walmart's a bad way to represent, but for example, this is just the ultimate in authenticity. It's like, am I going to go and work at Walmart and sell all of the things that they sell that I don't even believe in or agree with selling, or I don't even like? Or could I develop my own company making my own products, maybe even products that I don't use, and sell them myself? Well, I'll tell you what I choose. I choose to sell those products myself because I don't want to be a Walmart slave, and I don't think that you do either. And hey, if we both end up slaves for Walmart, then I guess that's the reality of life. But that's not where I'm going. My will and what I will to do is way different than that. So I hope this was helpful on some level, hearing my little rant about liberty and being authentic and going out and getting yours in the best way that you know how. And thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.